Is your touchpad not working on your Windows laptop and you're not sure how to turn it on? Well, in this video, we're going to show you how to enable and disable your touchpad only using your keyboard on your laptop. It's really easy to do. Now, I've got three different laptops here. I've got a Lenovo laptop, I've got a Samsung laptop, and an older HP laptop. We'll show you how to do it on all three of them. They're all slightly different, but fairly similar as well. So hopefully this will be able to solve your problem. So check it out. Hey everyone, it's Ken here from Northern Viking Everyday. If you are new here, we bring you videos on reviews and how-tos, so make sure you click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. Today we're going to be showing you how to enable and disable your touchpad only using the keyboard on your laptop. And as I'd mentioned, I've got three different laptops here. They're all slightly different. I've got a Lenovo, I've got an older Samsung, and an older HP, all running Windows, and you should be able to figure it out for your laptop using what I'm going to show you today. Now, if you don't want to use the keyboard to do this, I will create another video. It'll probably be the next video that comes out on how to do this in the settings. So watch for that video if what I'm showing you today doesn't work. But let's jump on over to my computers, or my laptops, I should say, and show you exactly how this is done. All right, so here we are on my Lenovo laptop. The touchpad is currently working perfectly. And the first thing we need to look for is our function keys here at the top of our keyboard. I've got F1 all the way through F12. And if I take a closer look, I'm gonna see all sorts of little icons at the bottom of these. And those are different functions that you can do here as well. But in order to access those functions on this computer, I have to hold down the function key, the FN key right here, and I can access any of these. So if I look closer, you're gonna see F6 actually has a little logo of your touchpad with a line through it crossing it out. So if I go ahead and hold down the function key and F6, all of a sudden my touchpad stops working, which is super handy. Maybe I'm writing an essay and my cursor's jumping all over the place and I need to turn that off. Now, let's go ahead and turn it back on. The same thing, function, F6, and all of a sudden it starts working again. Now, it's gonna be slightly different, as I mentioned, on the Samsung and the HP. So let's jump on over to those and show you how to do it there as well. So over here on the Samsung laptop, again, the touchpad's working. And if I have a look at the function keys again, it's different this time. You can see that F5 actually has an X through the touchpad. So again, we're gonna hold down the function key, hit F5 this time, and all of a sudden the touchpad is gonna stop working. And again, function, F5, and again, it is up and running. Let's jump on over to the HP, which is probably the most different out of these three laptops. All right, so here we are on the HP laptop. If I have a look here on the function keys on this laptop specifically, I'm not gonna see any touchpad logos here. Now, your HP might have one, and again, you could do the function and that option if you do. On this laptop, actually, I have a dedicated button right here. So look around on your laptop, you might have a dedicated button that just turns the touchpad on and off. So if I click on that, all of a sudden my touchpad stops working. And I could click on it again and it'll start working. And it's that simple for all these laptops to turn your touchpad on and off. So I hope this tutorial was able to help you out in enabling and disabling your touchpad on your Windows laptop using the keyboard. If it did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. And also remember, the next video I am creating is how to enable and disable the touchpad using the Windows settings, not the keyboard. Watch for that video. I'll put it in the cards here at the end so you can easily find it. Thank you so much for watching today, and until next time, take care.